What's going on YouTube? My name's AJ and today we're going to be reviewing the Supreme Stone Island Corduroy 500 jacket that came out just recently, a few weeks ago, for the fall winter 2020 Supreme drop. And we're going to see how it fits, is it worth the money, and should you buy it? Let's get it. Stony. So this jacket is made by Stone Island in Italy. And it's a collaboration with the Italian brand and the ever popular Supreme skateboarding brand. And this jacket is made out of a water repellent cotton corduroy, which has a frosted look to it, which is very significant in regard to how Stone Island makes their clothing, their dyes, and their whole technology behind their fabrics, their production and everything. So just in hand, my first impressions is that this piece is extremely luxury in regard to sportswear and streetwear compared to other pieces that I've had in the past. This is my first Stone Island piece, and I think it's really awesome that they collaborated with Supreme. I'm really, really impressed. I definitely get how Stone Island is expensive, but I think it is expensive for the right reason. And if you ever get a chance, I would strongly recommend going on stoneisland.com and checking out some of the videos they made on the way they work with fabrics, the way they work with technology in regard to their production, dyeing, and just how their garments are made. I think they have an archive of over 40,000 garments that they reference. And what I really like about Stone Island after watching those videos on their website is that they have a certain fabric dye recipe for each color fabric that they make. And this one in specific is the orange that looks frosted, but it's really like a bright orange. But if you look really close, it does look kind of like white and frosted, but I don't know, it feels really luxurious and typical of like what a corduroy feels like. And this jacket also has two drawstrings in the hood area. On the back of the jacket, it has the Stone Island Supreme collaboration logo in a tonal orange that matches the frosted 500 corduroy. And it has three circular vents on each side, I guess to make it more breathable. This jacket has a full zip closure with a YKK zipper and a orange zip pull in an orange fabric. It has a total of 5 hidden snap buttons in the placket, and it seems like there is a elastic on the hem. This jacket has a total of 5 pockets. 2 of them are on side slits. Another 2 are pleated hidden snap placket pockets on the left and the right, like the side slits. And the 5th and final pocket is right below the Stone Island logo in the hidden placket itself. So it just snaps right there. I've actually never had a Stone Island piece before, and I didn't know that it's actually stitched on. I thought it was like a snap button placket, like a metal button, but it's actually stitched on. And what's cool is that Stone Island provides all the extra trim, including medals or, you know, embroidery that you need to put on. For example, like if this Stone Island button accidentally were to come off, there's a pair of extra Stone Island buttons on the inside of the jacket. And then in the pocket, it came with some extra metal trimmings for the buttons, for the zipper, and everything else. And the jacket came with a Stone Island branded hanger. And it also came with this blue garment bag. I think if you ordered this jacket straight from Stone Island direct, you would get a Stone Island branded garment bag. And I ordered this jacket direct from Supreme.com. And they gave me this bright blue translucent bag, which is cool, but not the same as a Stone Island garment bag. So I got this jacket in a size medium and it retailed at $658. I'm gonna put the StockX price right here to see how much it is. This is not shoes, so I don't know how much the resale is gonna be, but I actually don't resell any of my clothing or sneakers. So I'm just gonna review this as a consumer and as an enthusiast, because I think after wearing this jacket, I have become a Stone Island enthusiast. I know that this price range for Stone Island on the Supreme website, it's pretty expensive in regards to like what Supreme usually puts out, but if you look at what Stone Island puts out on the regular on their direct website, it's actually pretty expensive as well. So I'm not surprised that a lot of the Supreme community was saying that it's really expensive. That's just kind of like picking your taste, right? Like you like what you like, you buy what you buy. And I personally resonated with this jacket a lot, and I like the way that it looks. I have a weird knack of seeing how it fits in pictures and knowing how it's gonna fit exactly on my body based on my weight. And I'm about 5'9", 175. And this is me, you know, eating during this quarantine. And this is the size medium. It fits a little cropped, so I'm gonna say that the torso fits pretty loose. The arms and everything else fit pretty loose as well. But since this is going for like a retro kind of feel. The fit at the hem of the jacket, so the bottom of the jacket, is a little bit cropped, and they try to compensate that by having this elastic at the hem of the jacket, and I think it's a really nice touch. And for the pros of this jacket, I'm gonna say that this jacket is something where you won't know the quality until you have it in hand. I really like Stone Island based on this piece, not just because it's a Supreme collabo. I actually bought some other Stone Island only pieces that I'm gonna be reviewing, just because this piece really ignited my, I'm not gonna say love, but a slight obsession with it now. So I don't think I would wear this Stone Island top with a Stone Island bottom. I'm turning into a football hooligan. For those who don't know, Stone Island is actually looked at in a different way compared to just streetwear and fashion in certain parts of the world. I'll put a link below and where you can find more about that. But nonetheless, I think that I wouldn't wear this Stone Island top with a Stone Island bottom because it's kind of like matchy-matchy. It's doable. Maybe I'll do it once I do a review of the Stone Island pants that I'm getting, but stay tuned for that. We'll have some video clips of me wearing the top and the bottom, and we'll see if it works. So the first pro is just the quality. A second pro is also the timelessness of this jacket. I know it's bright, so it's not like you could wear it everywhere, but it's a piece of outerwear that's not too heavy, not too light, and it feels quality. I know it probably looks like just an orange jacket with a Stone Island patch and a Supreme tonal Stone Island logo on the back, but once you have it in hand and you wear it, it's really dope. I think they took a lot of inspiration from like those old school 90s and 80s thrifted jackets that are a little loose from the torso and the arms, but also crop high with that elastic band. And I think that this is not only a statement piece that you could have, but it's also a staple piece that you could put in your wardrobe. I think this will live past many seasons. I wouldn't say you could wear this in the summer, it just wouldn't really fit. Maybe a summer night, but it's still kind of warm. And those are the main pros, just the quality. I had kind of high expectations and it kind of exceeded it, not only with the jacket, but with, you know, they gave me a Stone Island hanger and I wish I got the Stone Island garment bag. But overall, I think it's well worth the money. And as far as the cons go, this was about $718 shipped, including taxes and shipping from Supreme Direct. And I know that's actually a lot of money just for one article of clothing, but I think that investing in a piece like this is extremely essential in creating a wardrobe once you already have a wardrobe. For example, as men, we don't have as much things to wear or think about as far as our shape, you know, how things are gonna fit on us, whether it's tight or loose. It's kind of just like you put on the top, you put on the bottom, you put on some cool sneakers, maybe a hat, and you're good to go outside. For women, it's a lot different because there's a lot of other things that they have to take into account as far as their body and how things look on them and such. But for guys, it's pretty simple, you know, just wear what you want to wear. I'm trying to try new brands and I know that this is expensive, so that's one of the only cons where you could definitely just go to like a thrift store and get like an orange corduroy jacket. Granted, it's not gonna be the same quality, not gonna be Stone Island or Supreme branded, but still, you're probably gonna save a lot more money just getting this kind of style jacket. Price aside, there's no real con to this. Like, even if you were to buy this in the gray colorway and black colorway that it came in, I think that it's still a staple piece. Like, I could see my dad wearing this, I could see other dads wearing this to go fishing or even, you know, hunting or whatever you wanna do outdoors. If you think this is too expensive, you know, like I said earlier, you could go to a thrift store, or you could even explore the North Face, which is actually under the same company that owns Supreme now, the VF Corporation. But anyways, that's the only con I have for this jacket. It's pretty expensive, and like anything Supreme or hyped, it's gonna be hard to get. But overall, I think it had more pros than cons. I think it's a quality garment with an extremely high price point, but I personally like it a lot. What do you guys think? Leave a comment on what you guys think about this jacket or any other of the Stone Island pieces that dropped. Once again, my name's AJ. Feel free to hit the like button if you like this. Feel free to subscribe. I'm gonna be putting out more sneaker videos, more clothing videos, and more goodies to come. See you guys. Peace.